Hello everyone and welcome back to Astrox Imperium. This is Devlog video number 82 and we are taking a look at build 104 and 105. Today's date is September 22nd, 2020. Alright guys, so over these past couple weeks I've been working on a lot of the visual effects for various different aspects of the ship. You can see that we've got some different particle. All of the different engines have unique particle effects now, so that they're all completely different. And I also went through and played with some of the pathfinding, dealing with the way the engines were causing the ship to orbit at high speeds on these gates. So I've made a few tweaks and adjustments to that to help to reduce that. And right now, I'm going to show you some of the new visual particle effects for combat. So let's go ahead and open up here and spawn a few guys to kill. And here we go. Let's zoom out. That's it. And we'll go ahead and jump in here. Let's see what we can do. Wow, I might have spawned too many. Now, you will notice that aside from these new visual effects, you can see they're pummeling me, that I'm doing more damage to the raiders than normal as I have went through and revamped some of their damage calculation code. And you will notice some of these numbers are huge. I'm hitting 200 and 300s. Those are... ooh, that was pretty. Those are because of the... ooh, I better get out of here. I'm about to get killed. One too many raiders. Get. Ooh, barely outran them missiles. So, what if... oh, my God, no. You bastard. Oh, my gosh. What a mess. All right, well, good. This is where I wanted to be anyway. Because I want to show you guys that we've got these new missiles to play with. So if you go into here, you see we've got advanced cruise missiles, advanced missiles. So you've got all the basics, but now you've got the advanced and the heavies that can, I mean, look at this heavy cruise missile. That does some serious damage. But anyway, the game will actually generate these regardless if you've already created a save game or you have an existing save you're playing in. You will start seeing these missiles appear. However, they will not automatically be here in Biomate at Void Starcross. Only new games will have those unless you want to manually edit those files into your station, which is not difficult to do. It would take you just a few seconds. You can find information about that on the forum or just hit us up on Discord and be happy to walk you through it. But anyway, the raiders will drop these missiles. You will find them being generated in various stations and things like that. And if you create a new save, you will see them already in Void Starcross. So that is good. I've also added, this devlog is covering build 104 as well, that we now have in the offices a new tutorial for drones. You can see we've got a drone tutorial here. And once you get through all the basics of the drone tutorial, he will give you a document for your journal that walks you through all the drone stuff. So there's lots of information in here, even breaks down all the different types of drones and things like that. Good little piece of info to have in your journal. So you can pick that up at the Void Starcross station in the offices. All right. I've been spending a little bit of time, you know, working with the visual effects of these, you know, particle systems and things for explosions and combat and things like that. However, I haven't had a chance to touch the sound, and that is part two. So hopefully all of these new sounds and some sound revamping and some code changes will be available in build 106 to go along with all the visual stuff that I've added in 105. So hopefully that will pair up nicely together and make things a little bit better visually for the game. I normally don't play other games when I'm developing, simply because I have an addictive personality. I will fall into another game and then stop working on Astrox, and you guys will be like, what the hell? Momo's over there playing fucking Minecraft or some weird shit. And to avoid me doing that, I just don't play the games. Well, I broke my rule recently. It was last week, and there was a couple games on sale that I had been looking at for a long time. And even though I don't necessarily... I've had Elite Dangerous in my library for over a year and a half. Never played it. Never touched it. Simply because I know that's the kind of game I can get sucked into, and I don't want to fall into that trap. I want to stay sucked into my own game. If I stay working on Astrox, then, you know, I make progress. And if I'm playing other games, I'm not making progress. But by poking around in the games for just a few minutes, mainly what I was looking for are, you know, what is the 2020 standard of introducing people into a new mechanics or a complex game, the tutorial systems that they're using. And although I learned a whole bunch about what is seems to be the community accepted standard and what people are looking for in these introduction tutorials, it was just very daunting because I realized, you know, there's a lot of work that has to go into producing all of the voiceovers and all of that stuff. And it's just, it almost broke my heart a little bit. Like, I don't know if I could ever get to that level, if I'll ever be able to get to where, you know, it's a AAA style game that makes you feel like, you know, every base is covered and every corner is polished. And I just don't know if I can get to that level, but that doesn't mean I ain't gonna try. I'm gonna keep fucking going until, you know, I die. So we'll see how that works. But anyway, it did give me a lot of insight onto some simple things that I could do to help to improve the introduction into the game and things like that. So that is definitely something that's on my radar. All right, so for the future, what I am currently working on is I'm working on the sound effect stuff, and I'm working on these new NPC interactions that happen organically just flying around out in space. I had to tie in with some of the storyline scripting, the ability to create those spontaneous interactions. And after doing so, I realized it is probably good to make other use of those interactions. And I know I've discussed before where various different NPCs would have different modes of communicating with you, to where, you know, maybe they decide that they don't want to fight and they're going to try to buy you off. They're going to try to pay you more than the mission was for you to kill them. Things like that, to just add another layer of variance to the missions and the game itself by putting in these NPC interactions that, although are children of the parent, you know, communication going on, whether it's from a mission or it's from storyline interaction, it's still tied into that, but it's just giving you another layer that you'll be able to, you know, discover information based on, you know, how you choose to interact with those NPCs and those raiders. So that's something that I'm currently working on. I hope to have maybe some of the initial versions of that put together in the next couple weeks, but right now I am knee deep in sound effects code and just polishing off some of the remaining particle effects that I haven't got to touch. Some of the scan effects, some of the tractor beams. I'll go ahead and show you this. I did manage to make some changes to the mining beam. And the mining beam is a little bit better now, along with all beams. But I didn't get to the, I think the tractor beam. I don't think I got to that one yet. And I feel like I'm forgetting something that I should be remembering. But anyway, let's go ahead and turn this on real quick, and then you can check this out and see what I'm talking about here. All right, so you can see now that the mining beam has a different, you can see like these little particles flying back as the beam is cutting through the rock. So little by little, it's getting there. These simple effects, all the engines are completely unique and different. So you'll see how, you know, one ship with multiple engine types are going to have different types of effects. So little by little. All right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll be uploading all of this stuff here momentarily. And you might want to stay tuned and check back a little bit later today, because I have something that is completely unrelated to Astrox. It is a video game, and I want to show it to you guys because it's something that's dear to my heart, and I just couldn't let it go. I couldn't throw it out. But anyway, I know you're confused, like, what the hell is he talking about? Well, stay tuned, because I plan on doing another video sometime this evening, and hopefully you guys will get to see it. But anyway, thanks for sticking around. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll be back in about 2 weeks with some new goodies. All right, guys, Momo Guru signing out.